What's up, guys? Devin here from American Aquarium. Thank you for tuning in. Really appreciate it. Let's learn about how to either get clarification, level 1 sterilization, or level 2. This is important to know because many sterilizers are marketed as a sterilizer, but unless the science is right, you're more likely getting clarification. In some cases, might be okay just getting clarification, but if you understand the benefits of getting level 1 and level 2 sterilization, which can be bacterial all the way to virus protection, and then also, very important, boosting the immunity of fish. So we want to get the right sterilizer for our size tank and what we're trying to achieve for the stock we have in our aquarium or pond. So at the end of this video, we should be able to take a sterilizer clarifier and know, based on its design, how much gallons per hour per watt we can have per the gallons of water that we're using to know if we're getting clarification or sterilization 1 or 2. This information is proprietary to American Aquarium, as in this has been in the field tested on thousands of applications. We may have different recommendations in the manufacturer based on real world experience and if certain criteria is in place, which we feel is best based on lots of experience. So here's the 7 things you need to know to check off the list and know what type of clarifier sterilizer you have. Number 1, low water turbidity, as in pre-filter, a high bioload pre-filter to the sterilizer. This means that the water that's going to the sterilizer is already being pre-filtered before it enters the chamber of the sterilizer. It's safe to say that if a good biofilter is not in place before the sterilizer has to work twice as hard. And we've seen this many times out in the field where you could have the right size wattage, the right flow going through the sterilizer, but not having a pre-filter, and you still struggle with even clarification. And this is a common problem with ponds. Number 2, is the water going through the sterilizer between 68 and 104 degrees? This is a pretty easy one. Number 3, now this is more for the sterilizer design, is the gap between the lamp and the outer wall of the sterilizer less than 3 centimeters. This is also including the quartz sleeve, but from the lamp to the outer wall. Now if you think about it, a wider chamber, and even say a canister filter that has a sterilizer in the middle, water that goes closer to that lamp will be zapped better than water that's on the outside of the chamber that's getting less UVC. So we want a narrower chamber for aquariums, and then with ponds, we want a bit wider chamber because we're going to be putting more flow through it, but we still want to consider that chamber size. Number 4, does the sterilizer have a reasonable dwell time? This means water entering the chamber of the sterilizer, is it going to stay next to a lamp long period of time? More economy sterilizers will have a short lamp, meaning a short dwell time. The longer that that water can sit next to that lamp is the longer that it can be zapped. Most filters equipped with the UV and submersible UVs have poor dwell times. Number 5, is the water flow pattern through the sterilizer and around the aquarium and pond a good pattern? As in, we're taking water from this side of the aquarium or pond and going through the sterilizer, and then it's being delivered to the opposite side to the aquarium and pond. We want a full turnover, so there's no stagnant water that's not being brought through the sterilizer. Number 6, is the lamp and more importantly the quartz sleeve clean? A dirtier quartz sleeve is going to allow for less penetration of that light to go through it. And number 7, which is arguably one of the most important things because it really determines the difference between a quality sterilizer and an economy sterilizer, is the lamp used. We are looking for hot cathode, low pressure lamps, not the same as sold in discount stores. And it's also the same as a nail curing lamp, which is a medium pressured lamp. Medium pressure lamps are going to have about a 7% UVC output, where the low pressure lamps are going to have about a 35% UVC output if we were to look at the spectrum. This makes a huge difference. It's common for discounter UVs to use the medium pressure lamps because they're cheaper, and many replacements online are also these medium pressured. We're going to be able to break our sterilizers based on design up into a category A, which is premium, B, which is a little bit less economy, and C being poor. And then along with those categories, A, B, and C, we'll be able to determine how much flow to get the proper clarification level 1 and level 2 sterilization. If we use a medium pressure lamp in these sterilizers, even if they have a decent design, we can pretty much guarantee that we are going to have to slow the flow even more to get a better contact time compared to a low pressure, which then can lead to other issues of not having a full turnover. So now onto the AAP flow rate turnover graph, which is going to be able to tell us for category A, B, or C, this is the flow rate that we're going to need and the turnover to get either clarification level 1 or level 2. Make sure to check out the description. This information is only found on American Aquarium. An example of category A would be a premium TMC or Aqua brand. An example of a category B would be, say, the Economy Sun Sun or CUP and Tetra brand sterilizers. A category C would be much of what you can find on, say, Amazon.com, Chewy.com. Now on to the flow rate turnover table, only found on American Aquarium. Again, this is based on using these type of sterilizers on thousands of applications and running the math based on the results that we were seeing. So for clarification, this is green water control, which is used on all applications, aquariums and ponds. Ponds, this is most of the time what people are looking for. For category C UVs, we need at least 30 to 40 gallons per hour per watt. We're turning it over once per every 2 to 3 hours. So this is usually achievable by most clarifiers and sterilizers. Category B sterilizers, we can do 40 to 50 gallons per hour per watt and still turning over once to 2 to 3 times per hour. Category A, we need 50 to 60 gallons per hour. So you can see that we are able to have a higher flow, not slowing the flow so much, or even say 70 gallons per hour for a super high exposure dwell time UV. And so we take that 50 to 60 gallons per hour and times it by the watts, and are we turning over at least once every 2 to 3 hours? That's for clarification. Now when we move on to level 1 sterilization, which is for bacteria, some virus, and which is recommended for all aquarium, and if we can, some pond applications. A level C sterilizer, we need 15 to 20 gallons per hour per watt and turning over 1 to 1.5 times per hour. Category B is 20 to 30 gallons per hour per watt with that 1 to 1.5 times per hour. And the category C, you can see we're able to get more flow, we're not having to slow the flow so much to have a longer dwell time, is 30 to 35 gallons per hour, and are we turning the application over 1 to 1.5 times per hour. Level 2 sterilization, which this is for parasites, stubborn viruses, and even can be used on swimming pools or swimming ponds. This is going to be best for disease prevention, but also best for boosting immunity long term. UV sterilizers have an effect on the water that's similar to adding electrolytes. They reduce oxidation, which is from acids in the aquarium. It's a very interesting science. For a level C sterilizer, this level 2 is not possible. For a level B sterilizer, we need a very slow flow. We need under 8 gallons per hour per watt, and we need to turn over the application 2.5 times to 3 times per hour. So we need more repetition of the water passing that sterilizer along with a slower dwell time to get that extra punch of sterilization. And with a category C premium UV, we need 10 to 12 gallons per hour per watt and still turning over 2.5 to 3 times per hour. When we're thinking about this table, more important and more times than not, the flow rate will trump the actual turnover, but we need to stay in a range of considering the turnover, and we want to turn over the application, the aquarium and pond, somewhere in this range. Are we at least turning it over, say, once? Okay, so we want a level 2 sterilization, and we want to get the right wattage, and we got a nice slow flow, but are we turning over the water at least, you know, this many times? And if not, you will not achieve that actual sterilization because the water is not actually going through that sterilizer as many times as needed. And the water needs to be zapped multiple times to achieve this level 1 and level 2. So I hope that makes sense to you guys. I know this is a complex subject. Make sure to ask your questions. I want you to know I appreciate you very much. We have this information on our website for your reference. I hope you took notes. But if you figure out how to use this, you know, just take your watts of your sterilizer and times it by the gallons per hour, and that will tell you, and then times it by the gallons per hour in this graph, that'll tell you about how much flow for that wattage of sterilizer. And of course, American Aquarium Products has this information listed out on each sterilizer that they recommend and sell on their website, so we make it nice and easy for you. Here's the sterilizer that's rated for this application, and this is what you're gonna be able to get, level 1, level 2. All right, I want you to know I appreciate you guys very much. Make sure to like, subscribe, share, of course. You guys know the deal. And I will talk to you guys next time. Bye.